Now, everybody in this audience, I'm sure, will be aware of the wildly inaccurate and overly pessimistic math models predicting COVID cases, hospitalizations, and deaths that were used to justify the draconian lockdown measures starting spring 2020. But what you might not be aware of is the extent to which the same flawed models have been used to claim that the lockdowns and subsequent vaccine programs were successful. And to explain this by way of analogy, imagine that I recalled the average daytime temperatures of London from January up until the end of July. And then using appropriate math modelling, I predict the temperature trend here for the rest of the year based on my observations up until the end of July. Now, of course, this prediction of worryingly higher temperatures assumes that we don't introduce any intervention to prevent this from happening. So my intervention is to turn a fan on in my garden at the end of July. And I then observe the actual temperatures after my intervention. And note that whopping difference in temperature that my intervention has achieved. This, for example, is essentially how the Imperial team, although it's a different one incidentally to Neil Ferguson's, got to their claimed 20 million lives saved worldwide from the vaccines. They calculate the difference between their own predicted number of COVID deaths and the actual observed number of COVID deaths.